Oh, Rabbi, 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 R Lord, we surrender to you, Lord. Yeah. yanı basılı olması. Bu aşkın yaradığı olma. Yanları bana sende. Bana bana sende.
Yes. Roma, us to do what you want. Use me, Lord, let it start here. Let it start here. Let it start here. Let it start here.
Bye. Oh, yeah, I'm not sure. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, bless them here. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord, for your visitation, God. Hey, thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Oh, bless your name. Hallelujah. I lift my hands in total adoration unto you. Hallelujah. You reign on the throne, for you are God and God alone. Because of you, my cloudy days are gone. Thank you, Lord. I can sing to you this song. I just want to say that I love you more than anything. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Yeah, God. Hallelujah. I lift my hands in total adoration unto you. That's what I want to do, saints. You reign on the throne. Ha! Thank you, Lord! Hey! Hallelujah! For you are God, and God alone. Because of you, my cloudy days are gone. I can sing to you, Lord, this song. And I just want to say that I love you more than anything. Oh, hallelujah. I just want to say that I love you more than anything. One more time, I'll say it one more time. I just want to say that I love you more than anything. Hallelujah, that was just on my heart. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus.
Glory!
Oh! Thank you.
Love you, Lord, healer in the midst. Love you, Lord, healer of the heart. This is the name of the Lord.
Oh, Behold, Yamamasi and the Lobo Cosata, Eria Rakata. Thank you, Lord. Look for change, say the Lord Rabasata. Oh, look for turnaround, say the Lord Rabasata. Telebosata. Look for turnover, saith the Lord. Rama sete. Oro shobo reba masa tora babaha. Ori baba si andolo oko si andele di anda. Aria soto lobo raba basia. Thank you, God. I hear the Spirit of the Lord sing, I have chosen you, Korabasata, for this end time harvest. Ikotorobo Koraba. Erasata. I've chosen you for this end time harvest. Rimastalamo yekete rosoto rabata. Thank you, Lord.
Hey, shut up.
Thank you, Jesus. Souls are coming. Souls are coming. Katolama. Hey, God. He's preparing us for a great work. Thank you, Jesus. He's conditioning our hearts for a great work. Oh, bless his name. He's getting us ready for an end time harvest, end time revival that will shake the nations. Oh, God, we thank you. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, bless your name. Oh, bless his name. Honey, we're ready. Glory. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. Glory to his name. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Praise God. We praise God for this visitation this morning. And the Spirit of the Lord is still manifesting himself. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. I just want to share a brief word with you, and then we will go back into intercessory prayer. Amen. We left off on last month talking about the world, the enemy and his forces. Amen. And so we just want to expose more of the structure of the world. We're in this world, but we are not of it. Am I right?
Yeah.
Amen. So what is the world? The world is a structure that is in direct opposition to God. The world is in direct opposition to God, his plan, his purposes, and God's people. Amen. I believe a breakthrough will come for God's people when we realize the world does not like us. So we shouldn't strive to try to please them. Because the world is in direct opposition to God's plan, God's purpose, God's people. They don't love him, but God loves the world. We think that means the Christian, but he said God so loved the world that he did what? He gave his only begotten son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not what? Perish. That world that opposes him. Ooh, you understand the love of God. That world that's against his plan and his purpose, God loves them. Yes. Amen? But we need wisdom to recognize what is the world. Go to Galatians chapter 1 and verse 4. The first thing we need to know about the structure of the world is that it's evil. The world system is evil. Galatians chapter 1 and verse 4 says what?
Who gave himself for our sins.
Uh-huh.
That he might deliver us from the present evil age.
Mm-hmm.
According to the will of our God and Father.
Okay, and one version it says that he might deliver us from this present evil world. So the scripture declares that the world is evil. They oppose God. They are against his plan. They are against God's purposes. The next thing we need to know is that the world system, of course, is without God. Galatians 2:12.
For before certain men came from James,
mm-hmm.
he would eat with the Gentiles. But when they came, he withdrew and separated himself, fearing those who were of the circumcision.
Okay, Ephesians 2:12. Ephesians chapter 2.
Ephesians chapter 2:12.
Mm-hmm.
That at that time you were without Christ,
mm-hmm.
being aliens from the commonwealth of Israel and strangers from the covenants of promise, having no hope and without God in the world.
Okay, so right there, the world system is without God. Having no hope and without God in the world. Amen. And let's keep the King James. Do you have King James? Okay, let's go to 2 John 7. We have to realize that in this world is much deception. And the deception is set up to ensnare believers to become a part of the world. And the church needs to wake up because we have allowed the world to come in and influence the church. I know I'm telling the truth. I might have to stand alone, but I'm going to stand up here. We've accepted a lot of things that the world has approved of. And they are full of deception, and we have brought it into the church. I could start, okay. Come on, who's over back there thinking?
For many deceivers have gone out into the world.
Uh-huh, they gone where?
Into the world.
Deception is in the world.
Who do not confess Jesus Christ as coming in the flesh. This is a deceiver and an antichrist.
Antichrist, anything against Christ. Even in our songs, there was a season, I hope it's gone, where people didn't mention Christ in their songs. They didn't mention Jesus. I'm talking about gospel singers. They took their name out because they wanted to influence the world. Now, I haven't been here, I've been there, but I heard you can go, there was a time you go in the club and you could hear some of our gospel singers' music being played. That's an antichrist spirit. Yes. Come on, church. Yes. Many deceivers are entered into the world and they confess that Jesus Christ did not come in the flesh. Every school is not for you. Just because it has a theological sign upon it. Because some teach against the virgin birth. You can't be saved if you don't believe that. Wake up, church. That's an antichrist spirit. Help us today, God. Glory. We can't jump up and join everything. Because everybody's not confessing that Christ came in the flesh. Everyone is not confessing that he was born through a virgin. And I know many pastors are hook, line, and sinker. Because they went to a particular school. They said, well, they didn't teach it, but I didn't care. Well, you done took all the little doctrine in. That's a form of deception. Amen? So we don't want to be ensnared as believers to become a part of the world system. That's why, and we shouldn't just use this scripture haphazardly, but we should use it daily. Yes. Trust in the Lord with all thine heart. Come on, help me out. Lean not to your own understanding, but what else? Come on, finish it. He will direct your path. Amen. That should be a daily standard for every believer. Because many of us get up, we go out into the world that we're not of, but yet we live in it. And we don't want to be caught up in worldly things. How many can say amen?
Amen.
And if we don't recognize, if we don't know what's considered to be worldly, we'll jump right on in there. That's why we have to trust in him. Yes. That's not just a cute little scripture to memorize. But it's a scripture to live by. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Because the world wants to ensnare us. The world is already judged and under condemnation by God. 1 Corinthians chapter 11, verse 32. The world is already judged and under condemnation by God. So if we have our people, our loved ones, our children, our children's children, whatever the case may be, anybody attached to us, we need to pray for their deliverance. They need to know that God so loved them. But if they don't come out, what does the scripture say?
It says, but when we are judged, we are chastened by the Lord.
Uh-huh.
That we may not be condemned with the world.
Come on. Because the scripture says there is no condemnation to them who are what? In Christ. We are chastened of the Lord.
Yes.
He'll chastise us. I'm too old school to tell me that God don't do all of that. He'll chastise us because he don't want us connected to the world that hates him. Come on. He don't want us to miss his plan and his purpose for our lives because we're so strung out with the world. The world is already condemned and judged by God. That's why you gotta love God and hate the other. Come on here. Thank you, Jesus. So we gotta thank God when he chastises us. Now he don't put sickness on us, make it plain. He don't make us bang our head against the pew. I'm not that old school. I've heard of that though. You know, he doesn't cause mass destruction in our lives to chastise us. But what he does is he woo us. He pursues us by the Holy Spirit. And makes us feel uncomfortable when we're outside of his will. How many can say amen?
Amen.
He's a good God. Thank you, Jesus. Now let's talk about the elements of the world. When we mention the elements of the world, it's referring to the elementary principles that govern the world. The principles that govern the world leads to spiritual bondage. Spiritual bondage. Let's look at the scripture and we'll talk more about spiritual bondage. Galatians chapter 4, verse 3.
Galatians chapter 4, verse 3. We're talking about the elements of the world.
Even so, we,
when
we were children, were in bondage under the elements of the world.
The thing that governs the world, that leads to spiritual bondage. That's why, because everybody's doing something in the church doesn't make it right. It could lead to spiritual bondage. We have excused everything nowadays. I'm talking about the church. We've excused a lot because we made God to be, and He is a loving God, that He don't care what we do, but that's not true. So everybody's into drinking now. I'm talking, I talk to some folks and I don't argue. I just don't want to get into it. But we have compromise. And because we have compromise, people will get into spiritual bondage. Come on.
Hallelujah.
We excuse smoking. God don't care if you smoke. I heard one lady say, well, why don't we just have a smoking session in the church? Why you wait till you go outside and do that? If God is cool with it. Those things lead to spiritual bondage. Because you can't tell me you can do that and walk free. That's an addiction. So now we're praying against the spirit of bondage in all its manifestations, and a part of that is addictions. You can't tell me you can be free. I know we can't because of the enemy. As soon as you leap for joy, he said, oh yeah, remember those cigarettes you just smoked? He's dirty. As soon as you want to take out of the devil, you dance, but you know when you go home, you're going to pull out that cigarette, that alcohol. You're in bondage.
Yes, yes.
Am I right?
Yes.
We have allowed things in the church. Come on, church. It's holiness. I'm going old school. Holiness or what? That was the word. I don't think we should have deviated from that. We might have needed to calm down a little bit. But we probably shouldn't have deviated from it. Somebody asked Medea, when you come into church? She said, when they get a smoking session. I hope that don't come to pass. Help us today, God. The things, the principles that govern the world lead to spiritual bondage. So if you don't want to be bound, I was reading about Joseph and Potiphar's wife. If you don't want to be bound, you better run like your hair is on fire to get away from some of these things. And we can't go by others' approval. We need God's approval. How many can say amen?
Amen.
Now the other part of the other part of the world is the rudiments of the world. Its principles, its structure. They are different from God's structure, God's kingdom. Go to Colossians chapter 2 and verse 8. And then we're going to skip down to verse 20. The rudiments of the world, their practices, their ordinances, their principles. We can't, I hear the Lord saying this, we can't take their structure even into a marriage. Right? Because the world might say it's 50-50. And the Spirit of the Lord says, it's all of you. Hey, glory to God. Hey, come on. Their principles, their structure. What does Galatians 2, 8 say?
Beware lest anyone cheat you through philosophy
and
empty deceit, according to the tradition of men, according to the basic principles of the world, and not according to Christ.
My.
Yes.
We have to be dead with Christ from the principles of the world. They don't think like God. The world may say, cheat everybody, backstab them, do whatever it takes to move up. Right? And God says what? Be humble and you will be what? They're not thinking like God. They may say cheat, steal, do whatever to make it for you.
Yes.
Especially if you're struggling financially. Do whatever you need to do to make it for yourself. But God says what? Give, and it shall be what?
Given to you.
Come on. We can't take their ways. Their ways are not like God's ways. So we are dead with Christ. Dead to the flesh. And if I get a few extra minutes, we may talk about the flesh. Maybe not. But the rudiments of the world, we have to be dead to them and subject to the things of God. How many love God today?
Amen.
Now let's talk about the spirit of the world. The spirit of the world is in direct... Oh, did we go to verse 20? Go to verse 20, I'm sorry. Did we go? Galatians.
Colossians
2:20, I'm sorry.
20. Therefore, if you died with Christ from the basic principles of the world, why, as though living in the world, do you subject yourselves to regulations?
Woo! Now he's not talking about, well, I don't have to obey the speed limit. I'm just making it plain. We have to obey the laws of the land, right?
Amen.
But if we are dead with Christ, then we are not subject to the rudiments, the principles, the ordinances of the world. We are dead with Christ. You know, sometimes we'll say, I've heard this, and then this is what dropped in my heart one day. God, more of you and less of me. And what dropped in my heart is, God, I need all of you and none of me. Because in me dwelleth, and my flesh dwells what? No good thing. I need all of you. And the me part be a vessel unto you. Come on here. I need all of God. And that part you don't want, I'll take that too.
Amen.
I need him just that bad.
Yes.
Woo, just that much. Glory to God. So we are dead to the things of the world. Let's not be deceived. The world comes out with a style, we come out with it too. They come out with a dance, we do it too. Y'all know I'm telling the truth?
Yes, Lord.
I saw a church, the whole church was doing line dances from the pulpit to the choir. I mean, they were going in. And I listened to a worldly rap singer, and he said, when I go to church, I want church. I don't want to go to church and feel like I'm in a club. I'm talking about a worldly rapper who's seeking, know he wrong, came out of his own mouth, unless they do those little tricks, I don't think so. But you know how they can do so much now with technology, but I believe this was real. Out of his own mouth, I don't know his name. He said, I don't want to go to church and feel like I'm in a club. I need God. You know, there's a void in their lives. Just like there was a void in our lives before we found the Lord. Am I right? That void can only be filled by God. God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. So they are trying to fill that void, and their drugs and their lifestyle is not getting it. So they go to church and they feel like they where they just come from.
My God.
Jesus.
That's sad. Come on, church. Most of us don't break and cry under the power of the anointing. I'm not going to declare that no more. I believe we got a spiritual breakthrough today. It was awesome. But if you go to the church of the Frigidaire, where nobody's crying out for God, nobody's seeking God, the world walk in and they don't tell, they can't tell the difference. They should walk into church and tears should start flowing because of the presence and the power of God in the house. Am I right about it? Glory to God. So the spirit of the world is in direct opposition to the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit. We need, let me calm down, get back. We need the Holy Spirit. Yes. Not just for speaking in tongues, but holy in our lifestyle. Come on, somebody. Where he is in full control. Where he fills the atmosphere. Glory to God. The Holy Spirit. So the world is in, the spirit of the world, go to 1 Corinthians 2:12. The spirit of the world is in direct opposition to the Holy Spirit.
1 Corinthians 2:12. Now we have received not the spirit of the world, but the spirit who is from God, that we might know the things that have been freely given to us by God.
Okay, so we have not received the spirit of the world. We're in a different kingdom now. With different kingdom principles. Come on here. We're in the kingdom with the King of Kingdom, with the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords.
Yes. Hallelujah.
Where the Holy Spirit is right up there with God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Spirit. He is not an afterthought. He didn't just show up in Acts 1 and 8. But in the beginning, he was right there, part of the Trinity. Thank you, Jesus. And he comes. Jesus said, I can't go. If I don't go, you won't get the Holy Ghost. Hey! Calm down, Deborah Moore. I have to go. So that he who comes after me can abide with you forever. Come on, Jesus. We love you. And he dwells on the inside of you and I. And he is the mind of God. You don't have to give away a piece of your mind. Just say, I need the mind of God. Holy Spirit knows everything. He knows the end from the beginning. He comes. Hallelujah. To talk about Jesus. Am I right? He comes to dwell into the hearts and the lives of the believers. So because of that, We will know the things that have been freely given to us of God. Anything of the world should taste bad to us, should look bad to us, shouldn't even feel good to us. Because the Holy Spirit's not okay in it. If the Holy Spirit don't say yes, you better run like your hair is on fire. Because we only want what he wants. Am I right?
Yes.
Oh, thank you, Lord. Somebody come on and give the Holy Spirit a praise.
Hallelujah.
Glory. Hallelujah.
Yes.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. He is of God.
Yes.
Thank you, Holy Spirit. I never read the book, but I like the title, Good Morning, Holy Spirit. The title was good enough for me. I need him to talk to me. I need him to help me. Especially when I ignore him. I know y'all don't. Been days I walked right past what he said. I heard you, but I'm just keeping it real. I might have said talk to him, but my actions did. I know y'all probably haven't. And all the misery on the other side of that of not waiting and listening to him.
Yes.
It'll draw you back again to his presence, to his direction, to his love for you. So we have not received the spirit of the world because the spirit of the world is in direct opposition to the Holy Spirit. Now there are philosophies of the world. Philosophies are principles of knowledge. The world has principles of knowledge. It has worldly philosophies that are not based on Christ. Scripture backs it up. Colossians, did we just read that? Colossians 2:8. Let's read it again.
Beware lest anyone cheat you through philosophy and empty deceit.
Stop right there. Through worldly philosophy. Knowledge that's not based on Christ. Amen. We don't want to be deceived. We don't want to take the wrong direction. We have the Holy Spirit. The will of God is not difficult to find. I remember reading as many books as I can on how to find the will of God. I was confused when I finished. More than I was when I started. Just love the word. Just love his presence. And you'll find yourself in the will of God. And guess what? The safest place to be in all your life is in the will of God. Somebody say, what is it? Got the perfect will, and what's the other one?
Permissive.
Mm-hmm. But it's of God, it's all good. I'm serious. We need to read that scripture again. Somebody find that for me. Is that Romans? What is that? This talks about the will of God is the perfect and the, where we get that from? We saying, y'all was saying something a few minutes ago. Where's the scripture? Romans 12:2, right? Somebody read that for us.
And be not conformed to the world, but be ye transformed by the renewing of your mind, that ye may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God.
Okay, so all of that sounds good to me.
Yes.
That is good. God is good. And acceptable, his acceptable will is good, come on. And his perfect will is what? Good. As we say, it's all good. You know what? Because he'll work it together. Hey, yeah. For our good. How many love him? Yeah. But we have to be not conformed to this world. We just talked about the philosophies, the elements, the rudiments of this world. That means their structure, their way of thinking. Be not conformed to it, but be transformed by what? Renew your mind. And we know where that comes from. We've got to love the word.
Yes.
Give me this day my daily bread, my daily necessity, my daily portion. Give me your word.
Yes.
How many love it? Joel said, I love it more than my necessary food. Now, you talking about somebody I like to eat. I'm not Joel, but I'm his sister. And I do know food is necessary. Glory to God. But we've got to love the word. Woo! More than my necessary food. Glory to God. That's the only way we'll be able to walk away from this world. I'm almost finished. I'll just give references. From now on, the world, the wisdom of the world is not God's wisdom. Scripture reference, 1 Corinthians 3:19, for the wisdom of this world is foolishness with God. They don't understand when we're following hard after God, why we will neglect some things. We should be, right? They don't understand why you don't go and drink. They know we go through things, but we don't drink to ease it. We don't smoke to take away the pressure of life. Am I right? We don't do certain things because our trust and our confidence is in God. That's foolishness to them. You know, they might say, if something bothers me, I'm going to get drunk as a skunk and forget it ever happened. Y'all know it. Some of y'all might have lived that way before you knew Christ. So I'm trusting in God. What? That sounds foolishness to the world. The wisdom of the world is foolishness with what? With God. The course of the world, the cycle of this, of the present world, this routine, the way the world operates. Scripture reference, Ephesians 2:2. Wherefore in time past you walked according to the course of this world. In time past, saints, we walk according to the cycle of this world. The course of this world. And who was our boss? The prince of the power of the air. We know who that is. That's Lucifer, Satan, and all the other things. Beelzebub. The spirit that now working in the children of disobedience. We were right there with them at one point. That's why we can't look down on folks. I brought this book. I'm passing it out to everybody in Harvest Time. Don't be offended. If you haven't got your copy, see me. I think I have some in my purse. Don't be offended. Because the way God tells us to handle things is different from the world. Am I right? God has a standard. And we should follow his standard, not the way we used to do. You tell me off, I'm telling you right back. Get in my face, I'm getting in yours. Look at my eyes, I'm looking in yours. Say something about my mom, I'm talking about yours. We can't operate like that. Am I right? Amen. We are not according to the course of this world. We're not according to the prince of the air who keeps devilment going, because he is the devil. The next thing about the world is the voice of the world. The voice of the world is contrary to the voice of God. 1 Corinthians 14:10. There are, it may be, so many kinds of voices in the world. And none of them is without what? Signification. Many voices in the world. That's why we have to love God's presence. Yes. Jesus said, my sheep know my voice, and the voice of a stranger they will what? Not follow. Amen. Because the world has lots of voices. The psychic hotline is the voice of the world. Horoscope is the voice of the world. Look at the first part of that. Horror. It's horrible. There are saints who, what's your sign? Oh, that's why we get along. We under the same sign. Our sign comes together. You better wake up, saints. What's your sign? The cross that's now empty because he's on the right side of the Father living to make intercession for you and me. Come on here. Glory to God. Let me put this in here. This is Memorial Day weekend. And in covenant, when you make a covenant, there's always a memorial for you to remember. That's a part of the covenant. I don't remember right now all the other parts, but one part is a memorial. And the memorial Jesus left for us was the cross. Hey, glory to his name. So we can't get rid of the cross because it's a part of the covenant. But one thing we know for sure, he's not there. Hey. He's in heaven. Praying for you and I. Somebody give him praise right there. Amen. So Memorial Day, they remember those who have died for this country. I was injured for this country. And of course, we make it personal. Remember our loved ones who have gone on. But we also remember Jesus. He who's no longer dead. And he's yet alive. How many love him for that? So there are many kinds of voices in the world. That's why we have to hear from the Holy Spirit. I remember this years ago, somebody wanted to go out with their friends. The Holy Spirit said, you better stay home. And because they did, they avoided a car accident. We better listen to the voice of the Holy Spirit. And we need to hear that every day. Yes. I have a routine to work. But I want to know, do I need to take that exit or go on around? Yes. Are you with me? Yes. Glory to God. Thank you, Jesus. We need the voice of the Holy Spirit. I'm almost finished in our prayer life. I was praying all through the night. I told Sister Cherry yesterday I was concerned about today, so I think we need a different format. Because this was not designed to come in and do the same thing the same way every month. Mm-hmm. So I'm a little bit nervous. So throughout the night, I'm praying for an outpouring. Amen. You know, we want to be spontaneous. Yes. We want to yield to the Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. Whatever you say, that's what will happen. Whatever you rule out, that's what will happen. Yes, yes. And we need that even in our personal prayer life.
Yes, yes.
Amen. So 5 o'clock is my time, but he might want you at 3 to cry out. Am I right?
Yes.
We want to hear his voice.
Yes.
Say, well, I read first and I pray and then I sing a song. Well, he might want you to sing first and then right on into his presence. Yes. Whatever you want to do, Holy Spirit, come on. I want to hear your voice. Thank you, Jesus. I love it. Do you love it? The peace of the world, we can't have it. Jesus talked about it because the peace of the world is temporary, it's fragile, and sometimes it's deceptive. That's why Jesus said in St. John 14:27, look it up. He didn't give us the peace of the world. Because it's fragile. It can change with the blink of the eye. The world can't give you peace. It's temporary. Amen? But what does Jesus say?
Peace I leave with you.
Uh-huh.
My peace I give to you.
Stop. Jesus is talking.
Not as the world gives.
Right.
Do I give to you.
Come on.
Let not your heart be troubled.
Yes. I'm ready to shout the victory. Come on. I'm sorry. Go. Keep reading.
Neither let it be afraid.
Stop. So Jesus, our only potentate, governor and ruler, said, the peace I give to you is not of the world. Because the world's peace is temporary. It's based on circumstances. It's based on situations. How many know I'm telling the truth? It's temporary. It's fragile. Come on. So Jesus said, I give you my peace. Woo! We ought to love him. And his peace says, don't let your heart be troubled. And don't be afraid. 365 times throughout scripture, from Genesis to Revelation, it says, do not be afraid.
Hallelujah.
I fear not. Every day you wake up, you should say, I am not afraid.
Hallelujah.
Glory to God. Then the psalmist turned around and said, when I am afraid, I trust in you. Hey, I'm still covered. Still covered by the word.
Hallelujah.
Amen. The sorrow of the world, I'm giving us reference, 2 Corinthians 7:10, is different. The for godly sorrow worketh repentance to salvation, not to be repented of. But the sorrow of the world worketh death. That's the scripture. The world does have sorrow, but it works to death. It might mean spiritual death. You're not getting anywhere, in other words. But when you're godly sorrowful, thank you, Jesus. It'll work to repentance. It'll work to salvation. We need salvation every day, which means rescue, delivered, set free. Not when you got saved 30 years ago, but every day. Thank you for salvation. The world, the attitude of the world is, the world hates God. James 4:4, know ye not that the friendship of the world is enmity with God? Whosoever therefore will be a friend of the world is an enemy of God. I can't afford to be God's enemy. I love him and I need him. And he loves me, right? For you as well. The world hates you. The world hates you. Why do you think they're supposed to love and stroke us and promote us? We ought to pray. You want a promotion, you better go to the throne.
Thank you.
You better stand on the word. They're not going to promote you because you're cute and sweet. They look all over you. If they are the world, because the world hates you. Sorry to bring you bad news. Jesus said it in St. John 15, verses 18 through 19. If the world hate you, you know that it hated me before it hated you. Is Jesus talking? If you were of the world would love his own. But because you're not of the world, but I have chosen you out of the world, therefore, the world does what? Continuously. TH means continuously. You say, well, I can change and be sweet. If they're the world, they don't care. They'll be sweet back to you, but it's deceptive. Come on. Wake up, children of God. Our standards and our stand for God is what should move for our lives. Amen. Since the world is made up of flesh-centered individuals who hate believers, We need to learn more about this powerful force called the flesh. And we might not get, we'll get that next month. I think next month is graduation, but I think we need 4-hour prayer before graduation. I do if nobody else doesn't.
Amen.
We need to talk about the flesh. I like what one church mother says, the flush. We need to talk about what is the flesh. Come on. Glory to God. How many love Jesus? Glory. He's called us out of the world. How many thank him? Thank you, Lord Jesus. Praise you, Father God. Glory to God. I was in my storage, I think it was last month, and I'm going to ask Sister Wayne to forgive me because I had went to her, I don't know how long ago, and asked her for a box for prayer requests. And it was just a matter of sharpening her trunk. She let up the trunk. It was beautiful boxes galore. And I chose one for prayer requests, and I felt that, I think Pastor at the beginning, at some point had asked me to do prayer requests. If you did, Pastor, forgive me. But I know prayer requests was in the mix somewhere. So, but I brought the box and forgot index cards. But I would like to know if you have any prayer requests. Somebody probably has paper that we go into this season of prayer. You can just bring your prayer requests up to the altar. This is our altar. Now, you don't have to put your name, but we don't want unspoken. If it's unspoken, then we can't speak for it or speak over it. But if anyone has a prayer request, thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. How many believe in for miracle signs and wonders? Thank you, Lord. I was watching this video as you're writing. It was Shambach and Bishop Patterson, who I think both are going on with the Lord, but they were in a service together. And how Shambach would just lay hands. And people got, I mean, these were real healings. Not the ones you paid them to do, but real healings that took place. It's like we need to get back to that. How many can agree? Well, somewhere we need to get back to it, where our altars are filled and people walk away healed, delivered, and set free. And I remember we laid hands on a lady who was deaf since a child. Told her, take out those earplugs. I tell you, a mighty deliverance. Hearing aids, I'm sorry. A mighty deliverance came forth, a healing. People that were on crutches, a mighty healing took place. And it's like this fourth Saturday, a part of it was miracle signs and wonders. And I know people have given victorious prayer requests. But how many need y'all want to see a manifestation, even in the prayer service? I do. Thank you, Lord. I believe we got a tremendous breakthrough today. Thank you, Jesus. Just bring it up. Hallelujah. Glory to Jesus. Praise him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Thank you, Lord. If you're still writing, say amen.
Okay. Amen.
I don't want to rush. Come on, let's praise him. Praise him. Oh, praise him in the morning. Praise him in the noonday. Praise him. Praise him. Praise until the sun goes down. Come on, let's praise him. Praise him. Oh,
praise him.
praise him, praise him, praise him when the sun goes down. Come on, let's love him, love him, oh, love him in the morning. Come on,
love him in the
noon. Love him, love him, love him when the sun goes down. His name is Jesus, Jesus, oh,
Jesus.
His name is
Jesus in the
oh, Jesus, 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 when the sun goes down. Come on, call his name like you mean it.
Jesus.
His name is
Jesus.
Oh, it's Jesus in the morning. And it's
Jesus in the noonday.
Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, when the sun goes down. Come on, let's praise. Come on, church. Praise. You are to
praise him in the morning.
You are to
praise him in the
noon. Oh, praise him. Praise him. Praise him when the sun goes down. Love him, keep it going. Love him, oh, let's love him. Let us love him. Love him, love him, love him when the sun goes down. To
praise him in the
noon. Praise him. Praise him. Praise him when the sun goes down.
Hallelujah.
Somebody in it now. Love. You are to love him. You need to love him. Jesus. How many believe that when we agree, God does it? Let's see. Amen. Thank you, Lord. I felt compelled to put my oil on it. Thank you, Jesus. Glory to God. Glory to God. Come on, church, hallelujah. Good. Come on, love on him, hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hey. Thank you, God. Woo, glory to Jesus. We count it done, Lord, in the name. Woo, glory to God. This is the confidence we have in him. If anything we ask according to his will, hey, we know he hears us. And knowing that he hears us, we know that we can have the petitions we desire of him. How many believers in the house? Glory. Good God, we believe you. Hallelujah. Come on, saints. Glory to God. Let's pray in the spirit. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord God. Come on, children of God. God, we thank you, hallelujah, you hear us before we call, you will answer. Jesus. We thank you for spiritual deliverance in the name of Jesus. Oh God, we come into agreement. Hallelujah. For our children to be saved and come to Christ before the year ends. God, we come into agreement that we are saved and our children are saved. Our seed is saved. We yourself into agreement in the name of Jesus. We bind spiritual death in all its manifestations. We bind it in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. The eyes of our children. Glory. God had that on my heart this morning. We need to pray for our children. Glory to God, not one family member will be lost. Our children will not be lost. In the name of Jesus, we cover our children with the word. We cover our children with the blood. Come on. We cover our children in the name of Jesus. And we decree and declare, my God, that what you called them to be is what they will be. In the name of Jesus, we rebuke bondages over our children. We rebuke spiritual blindness over our children. In the name of Jesus, we call them out of darkness and into your marvelous light. We call them out for drugs. We call them out of immorality. In the name of Jesus, we call them out, my God, out of perverse relationships. In the name of Jesus, we come against the spirit of perversion. We break your powers over our children. In the name of Jesus, you homosexual demon, we come against you now. Come on, church. In the name of Jesus, you lesbian demon, we come against you now. In the name of Jesus, you cannot have our children. In the name of Jesus, you cannot. Jesus, you spirit of poverty and lack, come on. We pull you down. You have to know the strong man. We pull you down, poverty and lack. In the name of Jesus, we release increase financially. Open doors. Money given to you. You will find money. Checks coming in the mail. Come on, saints. Children. Financial increase. In the name of Jesus, we will obey you with the money you give us, God. Forgive us when we disobey. Forgive us when we went the wrong way and took the money you gave us to take care of business. And we didn't do it, God. We know with you there is mercy, and with you there is forgiveness of sin. God, we want to be good stewards of what you give us. We want to be good stewards of what you plant in our hands. Oh, God, help us in the name of Jesus. As we come against poverty and lack, we pray for your wisdom. The wisdom that comes from you, God, in handling money. Come on, church. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. God, we thank you. Oh, God, we praise you. Oh, those who need it. God, when you needed that mule for your transportation, you said, go get that mule. I need it. Hatoro bo satala barre kerere borota. Arashando bo si andere di 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 ata. You said, if anybody asks questions, tell them the Lord needed it. We rebuke any lying car salesman in the name of Jesus. We thank you for good transportation that'll get us from A to Z. Woo, glory to God, everything that goes with it. In Jesus' name, we decree and declare, God. We thank you, Lord God, for financial blessings and bills being paid. In the name of the Lord Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. Oh, Coriande, Dio Sora. Aria Toria, Dio Santa. We thank you for salvation in this home. We thank you for saving this husband. And them that come to you, Father, you'll save them to the utmost. We thank you for salvation for this husband. In the name of Jesus, yeah, that he'll call upon you, Lord, as Lord and Savior. Come on, church. I need your help. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Woo, glory to God. Hey. We thank you for healing this baby's skin. In the name of Jesus, we bind the spirit of infirmity over this baby in the name of Jesus. God, we thank you right now. With your stripes, the baby is healed. Hallelujah. Glory to God. We praise you and thank you, God, for deliverance. Thank you for good health. in the name of Jesus. Touch, Lord, touch. Touch our sister, God, in the name of Jesus. Hey, God, just like the woman with the issue of blood. Reach out and touch your garment. God, we touch right now the hem of your garment for healing for our sister. In the name of Jesus, everything attacking her body, we command it to cease. In the name of Jesus. Thank you for saving her siblings. Woo! Thank you, God. Come on, saints. Hey, Jesus. My God, we thank you. We thank you for deliverance. My God, from worldly lust. In the name of Jesus. And we thank you for purification. We thank you for love for the word, God. Woo, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. To take authority over worldly lust. Your word is a lamp unto our feet, a light unto our path. Your word is healing to those that find it. And deliverance to our flesh. Ooh, glory to God. It's in the word. Who's ever standing for that? It's in the word. Thank you, God. We pray for our churches, Lord. We pray for our pastors, Lord. We pray, Lord God, that you'll have preeminence in our churches. We pray for the health and strength of our pastors and the first ladies of our churches. We pray for their children, God. To bless their children, that they will want for nothing, God. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. God, we pray for children that are missing.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Young people who are involved in sex trafficking and exploitation. God, we pray. For deliverance. Holy Ghost, we thank you. You are the detector. You know where these children are. God, we pray for a release. In the name of Jesus. We pray for a release, God. In the name of Jesus. We thank you for the detection of the Holy Ghost. We thank you for the discernment of the Holy Ghost. To discern where these babies are. Oh, have mercy upon them, God. We even pray for those who kidnap the babies. God, have mercy. Bring a release in our nation for missing children. Bring a release from sex trafficking. In the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, we thank you. Come on, somebody pray with me. Somebody else come up and pray. Sister Tansy.
Hallelujah. Father God, we thank you for your presence, God. We thank you that we can rely on you, that everything that you desire to do, you will do. And Father, as we cry out to you with a whole heart, mind, soul, and body, recognizing that without you we can't make it, but all things can turn around, come about, Lord. I thank you for the prosperity that you promised in your lineage, oh God. We are the heirs of your cup, Ashadarabosa. We're the heirs of your kingdom, Lord God, and we can do more things when we are fully equipped, oh God. We have no lack in you. We have every provision set forth, oh God. In the name of Jesus, we are strong. We are well able, Lord God. We are taking care of this temple, Lord God, that it will last for the journey, Lord God. We are fighters, oh God. We are in your army. We are willing, oh God. We are vessels of truth, oh God. We are standing up for righteousness in every situation, God. We're moving obstacles out of the way because of your word. We understand that your will is in us. to do and to be. Come with your power, Lord God, in our spirit, Lord God. Renew us and refresh us, oh God. Let the igniting of your word come forth like fire. Shut up, oh, shut up, shut up in our bones, God. Don't let us be weary in well-doing. Let us fight the fight of the good fight of faith, oh God. To draw those in that are broken, those that don't understand, oh God. There's a need in the house, oh God, for warning women, Lord God. For men that will seek your face and not just your hand. Begin to move in this house, oh God, as we position ourselves to receive. God, we're not just coming to be fat, God, but we're coming to pour out on our shop. Pour out on the people that need to know you. Pour out on those that are struggling. Pour out on those that won't come through the doors. Oh God, help us to be more like you, strengthening and girding up, oh God. Help us to understand your word is true and that we walk in right. We walk in your rights. Oh God, we walk in right, oh God, in the name of Jesus. Let our faith be renewed, oh God, that we can lay hand on the sick and they shall recover. Not before our show of fashion, oh God, but that your word is true and that men may see your good work and begin to glorify you and exalt your name. That those that are away from you, God, that have backslidden and turned their lives back to the world, God, we're drawing them in. One by one, God, from the north, the south, the east, and the west. Everyone is struggling in their flesh right now, God. They love the world, the things of the world, the things that bring them joy, they say. But God, when you come, in the fullness of your glory, we'll be able to discern the truth. We'll be able to discern the way that we should live. We'll be able to discern how to love one another, how to lift up your name, how to exalt you. We will discern your way. In a household, God, in the car we drive down the street, hallelujah, in the way we carry ourselves, in the very fashion of our thoughts, oh God, hallelujah, thank you, Jesus. Take us a little bit higher, Lord God. Some of us are weary. Take us a little bit higher, Lord God. Let us see your realness, oh God. Let us begin to manifest your truth like never before. Let us open up doors for those that are broken. Let us be an example to those that don't know what righteousness is. Let us begin to change the very atmosphere that we praise you in, oh God. You are an awesome God. Lord, you're an awesome God. You're deserving of the praise. You're deserving of the glory. You're deserving, Lord. Let your honor fill the place, oh God. Hallelujah. He's a worthy God. He's a wonderful God. He's a way-making God. Hallelujah. Attach your life. Attach your thoughts. Attach your possessions to the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Attach your purpose to the King of Kings and let it come in your life, the Lord. Hallelujah. Father God, we bless you for these that are here. Every petition that they have brought before you, Lord God. Every thought that has been spoken and those that are still inside of us. God, we just ask that you begin to step up inside of us. Get up, Lord. Rise from your rest for a moment, God. And hear your children's cry. And begin to answer us, God. For we love you and we trust you. We love you and we trust you. Have your way in this prayer like never before, God. Let us leave this place and be an example. Let our house begin to turn around right now. Let those that are against us, Lord, begin to understand that we are vessels used by you. Oh, God, let the life, hallelujah, that we live, be a blessing to you. It's for your namesake that we gather together. It's for your truth that we magnify you and we give you praise. You're an awesome God. Woo, hallelujah. 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 Lord, we love you, Lord. We love you today. Hallelujah. Move us a little bit closer to you, Lord. Hallelujah, that our ears are open to you, that our heart is open, oh God, that we're willing and obedient, oh God. We want so much, but we're not obedient. Help us to be willing and obedient, oh God, to pour out of our substance into the kingdom, out of our substance. For no one is lacking out of what we have, Lord, to bless those that are in a dire place. Father, continue to show us your face. Hallelujah. 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 Glory to the King of Kings. Glory to our Father. Hallelujah. He's so worthy. Hallelujah. Precious. Hallelujah. Sweet anointing. In this place, oh God, let your anointing fall on those. Hallelujah. That desire a touch from you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. They've been distant, God, but now they're seeking you. Hallelujah. With their hands up, surrendering all. Whatever's not like us, oh God. Begin to just come in the Shabbahaya. Thank you, Lord God. And begin to move it out of our thoughts, oh God. Begin, we willingly lay it down before you, Lord. Have your way, God. Sweep over our soul today, God, as we glorify you, as we lift you up, as we give you the praise. Husbands are coming back to wives. Households are being mended in the name of Jesus. Children are not running astray. We're taking order in the household in the name of Jesus. We're no longer laying back in the background. We're speaking up for our grandchildren and our grandchildren's children. Hallelujah. We haven't forgotten our own siblings. Oh God, our sisters and our brothers, oh God. We're lifting the other of our seat. We're standing in the very gap, oh God, for them right now, God. Somebody can't pray. They're so frustrated and hurting. Somebody can't move. Their body is enwrapped with pain. But God, you are here. You are here. We are pulling on you to do what needs to be done in the spirit realm. Holy Ghost, have your way. Touch and deliver. Set free like never before. And seal it in your Shabbatai. Seal it with your Holy Spirit, oh God. Seal it, cover it with the very blood of Jesus. Oh God, we just thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Woo, thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord, we lift you up. We lift you up. Higher, higher. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Keep us focused, God. Don't let us leave this place and then drop the prayer down, Lord. Let us keep focused. Keep praising you. Keep praying. Keep exalting you. Keep magnifying. Somebody's hurting. We're in the gap, God. Hallelujah. We're lifting them up out of the muck and the mire right now. They're standing in your Shabbaha. They're standing up over our Shabbaha. They're believing you, God. They're trusting you, God. They're going where you want them to go, God. You're turning them. Hallelujah. It's our testimony that your word is sure. And it is never changing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory to God. Glory. Come on, give him praise. He's heard us.
Glory to God. Glory to God.
If you believe the Lord answered that prayer, go ahead and shout to the Lord with a voice of triumph. Glory. Glory. Thank you, Jesus. Praise Jesus. Praise Jesus. The matchless name. The name of all every name. Hey, 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 hey. Yeah, God. Go ahead, thank the Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Demons,
Demons will have to flee. Come on, say it again. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. We have the victory. V-I-C-T-R-Y. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. Come on. Demons will have to F-L-E-E. Tell me who can stand before us when we call on that great name. What's his name? Jesus, Jesus, precious Jesus. We have the victory. How many believe it? I feel that in my belly. Oh, in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, we have the victory. Hey, hey. Yeah. Well, it's in the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus, demons. Demons will have to flee. Sing it again. Say in the name of Jesus, I have. In the name of Jesus. In the name of Jesus. I have the victory, I-C-T-R-Y. In the name of Jesus, in the name of Jesus, demons will have to F-L-E-E. Tell me who can stand before us when we call on that.
Amen. God is really using her in prayer, she laid out on the floor. She didn't tell us what she got from God. But she was down there a long time. People don't live in her face hard anymore. Amen. But that was, amen, some experience. And our prayers that God will really revive us and rejuvenate us and put the burning for souls of the lost. Amen. And the desire to see miracles of the supernatural in us. Amen. How many feel like you released all that you could release today? Amen. I think we got a whole lot more. A whole long way to go. Amen. But just think what would happen if we would just fully release. But I know sometimes we have to kind of do it in increments. We have to spend time in the Word. We have to spend time in praying in the Spirit. We have to do a lot of things before we can get to the point where God can really. But I was determined this morning that I was just going to let it all hang out. I didn't care what happened. When I first got it, I was slobbing and spitting and purging and rolling. Amen. I don't think it takes all of that, but I think that it does take complete surrender. How many can say amen? It takes complete surrender. And I tell you, when you, amen, get the fullness of it, and when God really manifests himself and really fully releases you on the inside, it makes a difference, doesn't it? Amen. Amen. The Bible says when they came and saw the grace of God, they were glad. The grace of God will really make you glad. Amen. And I was just happy that Sister Denise obeyed the Lord. When you get filled with the Holy Ghost, you don't have to pump and prime and ask people to do stuff. She sang that little song and they just got all over me. Just a little, we didn't have many words. But it was just the spirit of it. Just broke some yokes. And we just want to continue to seek the Lord. You know, I'd like to see all of our ministers broken and weeping between the porch and the altar. Wouldn't that be, that'll be a revival in itself. Amen. We might just, amen, have a revival with just with the preachers first and get them all. Would that be all right? That's where I need to start. Amen. I'm not sure everybody will be willing to do it, but I'm willing to do it. Amen. I'm willing to cry out until I break. Hallelujah. Amen. So we just want to keep praying and keep doing what we're doing and taking it, amen, higher and higher. Glad for our precious sister. She, Thursday morning, well, she stayed with us 2 hours. My Lord. Whoa, you know, I didn't feel like saying a whole lot of stuff, but I just cried out just then. And boy, I tell you, when I left this place, I don't know, I just was different. I know I was refilled. Amen. But there are many refillings. Suppose we did it every Thursday. Hallelujah. And we did this every Saturday. Oh, I'm telling you, you know, I tell you that we got to take the limits off of God. And also, when God refills and rejuvenates and revives, he always puts the spirit of liberality. And he meets all of the needs. That's one characteristic of a revival. God begins to meet the financial needs as well. Amen. 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 All right, so if we want to see God manifest himself in a greater way, amen, that means that we have to pay a greater price. We do a greater degree of yielding, amen. So we word up, that's one way of preparing, word up, amen, and then you pray every day. Don't wait until Saturday to come or Tuesday or Thursday to come to pray. To praise, sing in the Spirit wherever you are. All right. Father, we thank you for the Spirit of giving. We thank you, God, for what you have done with our hearts have received, what our ears have heard and our hearts have received. We thank you, God, for your outpour. We thank you for the ministry of the word and the vessel that you've used to flow through to bring into fruition the thing that you had established for this day. We give you praise and glory, and Father, we give back, amen, in the form of finances, how you have blessed us when we are ministered to. Lord, that we want to minister to the servant of the Lord. Lord, this is our faith and our prayer. Give you praise and glory in Jesus' name. Everybody say in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. So happy for everyone that came today. It always blesses me to see my friend, Sister Ava. I know she has to go. We've been friends for years. All the others. May the Lord bless you and keep you. May the Lord cause his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. May the Lord bless your coming in and your going out, your children and your children's children. May he bless your finances, your transportation, your job, and every part of your life, your body be blessed. And we give him the praise, the glory, and the honor that every trick, every plot, every scheme of the enemy is paralyzed and prevented from happening. And God, we thank you for it in Jesus' name. Amen.
I know you wouldn't say it if you didn't feel it.